Greetings, fellow citizens. This time we are testing the freelancer. We are shooting one size one missile. I have to watch this in slow motion. And one size two missile on its way. Again, slow motion. And shooting one size three missile. AT something front side and stern at maximum. And next we are firing one size 5 torpedo. Shields front side 57 I think and stern at maximum. And two size 5 torpedoes on the way. Fifteen front side and stern at maximum. And we are shooting one size 9 torpedo now. Shields front side down, stern at maximum, and the front of the ship is red. Can we see anything? Impact or cosmetic damage? Doesn't look like it. No, it looks pretty normal. The guns still work. We have normal SCM speed and afterburner. And looks like normal flight controls. Yeah, doesn't look damaged. I mean, yeah, the front of the ship is red and surely she cannot take much more. But it looks like all systems are working fine. And we are shooting one size 9 torpedo one more time to make sure it wasn't just a lucky or unlucky hit. Same result, shields front side down, stern at maximum, and the front of the ship is red. And I can still see nothing, no impact damage, no impact damage, no missing parts. And the guns work fine. And looks like normal flight controls. Yeah, this doesn't feel sluggish. This feels like normal flight controls. Thank you. The freelancer is really, really tough in 3.1.x and in 3.2.0. And we are shooting two size 9 torpedoes. I don't think she will survive. And we are shooting two size 9 torpedoes. 4. So let's talk about the result. Green is a freelancer in 3.1.x and blue is a freelancer in 3.2.0. I didn't test size 1 and size 2 missiles in 3.1.x. When we are looking at size 3 missile, one size 3 missile brought the shields down to 83% front side and stern max, and exactly the same number in 3.2.0. Size 5 torpedoes in 3.1.x, shields 54% front side and 15% front side when we are shooting two size 5 torpedoes, and exactly the same numbers in 3.2.0, 54% and 15%. And when we are looking at size 9 torpedoes, it's pretty much the same result as well, with one small detail. For whatever reason, CIG reduced the AOA radius of size 9 torpedoes in 3.2.0. I'm not sure if this is intentionally or a bug. We will see in the future. In 3.1.x, one size 9 torpedo hit all four shield faces. All shields were down. But in 3.2.0, one size 9 torpedo, when hits the front of the freelancer, doesn't reach the stern shield, so only the front and side shields were affected. But the result was pretty much identical. The front of the ship was red in 3.1.x and it was red in 3.2.0, but all systems were still working fine. And as always, you can find a link to this spreadsheet in the description below. So, where do I rank the freelancer in 3.2.0? Let's take a look. I rank the freelancer tougher than the Cutlass and not as tough as Andromeda. The reason is the shields of the freelancer are stronger than the shields of the Cutlass, as you can see. And the freelancer can swallow one size 9 torpedo, the Cutlass can't. Now, if you are looking at the numbers of the freelancer and the numbers Andromeda and Aquila, those are pretty much identical. 54, 15, 54, 15. So why do I rank the Andromeda tougher than the freelancer? Well, the toughness of a ship is a mix of three factors. First, how strong the shields are. Second, how much hit points the ship has, and third, what armor and what quality of armor the ship has. At the present, we don't really have armor, so at the present it's just shield strength and hit points. And the Constellation Andromeda has more hit points than a freelancer. So how do I know this? Well, there's this great fantastic site, Malogos Star Citizen Database. I put a link to this site in the description below as well. And on Malogos site you can find tons of information about missiles, about missile damage, about torpedo damage, about guns, fire rate, DPS in, I think, in 10 seconds, in a minute, and so on and so on. And you can also find information about hit points of the ships. So, another row filled, only so many more to go. I hope you had fun watching this video, and see you next time. Bye!